In order to be successful in this course, you must become adept at using stick figures to represent organic structures. Stick figures are by far the most important time-saving device for drawing even moderately complicated structures. I'm going to illustrate how useful they are by first drawing the Lewis structure for 2-chloropentane. And you can time me as we go here. Put a chlorine here. Have to fill in the octets with hydrogens. Yes, this is taking a lot of time, and I haven't even labeled my carbons and hydrogens yet. Lewis structures have the most information, but they take the longest time to draw. As you can tell, this is not a complete Lewis structure yet because we do not have the lone pairs on our chlorine. And you can stop timing me right now because I'm finished. That took a long time. We can save time by drawing a condensed structure for the same species. This is the Lewis. This is the condensed. Bent structures do not need to show all the bonds. You can time me starting now. Not quite finished. I have to show the chlorine off of this carbon here. And I'm done. Please note that if you're not asked for a Lewis structure, you do not have to provide lone pairs. Only when you ask for a Lewis structure do you provide all the bonds and all the lone pairs. That still took quite a bit of time. Let's get right to the stick figure. And you can start your time right now. I'm done. Well, fiddling around there could have done a little faster. All right, there, you have your stick figure representation. When we're doing stick figures, not only must you be able to draw them, you also must be able to determine the formula of the molecule from the stick figure. Okay, so there's the structure, and these are all the same molecule on the page here, so clearly the end of a stick right there represents this carbon here, and I know it has three hydrogens on it because the only bond that's showing is that bond. Carbon, if you don't know already, burn this into your brain, carbon always has four bonds. So what atoms are missing on stick figures? Hydrogens attached to carbon. I repeat, the only thing missing on stick figures are hydrogens attached to carbon. So, if you see one bond to carbon, that means there are three H's. If you see three bonds to a carbon, which I do on the second carbon, which is one H. If you see two bonds to carbon, it's two bonds I'm missing there to H. Two H's here because two bonds are showing. Only one bond showing at the end of a stick, therefore three H's. So your formula, C5, corners are carbons, where sticks meet. Ends of sticks are carbon, unless you have the end of a stick that has an atom that isn't carbon labeled. So C5, counting up the H's, 3, 4, 6, 8, 11. And then after C's and H's, you list the other atoms alphabetically. Okay. Classification of carbons. Classification of carbons. What do you count to classify a carbon? Well, let me show you the final answers here. That's called a primary carbon, as is this. Why? Because this carbon has one bond to another carbon. This is a primary carbon because it has one bond to another carbon. That logic makes this a secondary carbon. Notice how I said that, secondary. Why? Because it has one bond to carbon there to the left, one bond to carbon here to the right. That's two bonds to carbon, making this a secondary carbon. You only count bonds to carbon for classifying. Later in the course, and the next course, you're going to see that classification has a bearing on the behavior of atoms. So right now we're just learning how to classify without knowing why it's important. This is a secondary carbon because it has two bonds to carbon, as is this because it has two bonds. So we'll finish this short video with an exercise. I want you to generate the formula for a molecule and classify all of the carbons. Formula. Classify all of the carbons. Start off with a ring. There like this. This is not even considered a complicated structure. So oxygen in there. There. Notice when I draw N, you are not allowed to omit this H. The only H's that are omitted, I will repeat, are H's attached to carbon. Okay. So, why don't we use the asterisks for carbons? The end of a stick is a carbon. Meeting of sticks. Count your carbons. Seven in the ring here. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. H's, I'll put a dot for each H. Got a dot there. End of a stick, three dots. Clearly this is an H, I'll put a dot. A carbon with three bonds showing has one dot. A carbon with two bonds showing is missing two bonds to H. I'd like to point out, we need to get to the point where we're not doing these dots. Just an introductory exercise. Three dots for the stick at the end here. And a single dot here. Here. And I missed this one at the end here. I believe I've counted all the dots, counting them up. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 18, 19, 22, 24, 26, 29. How do you list the alpha atoms at the end? after C's and H's, they go alphabetically. And then O. That's the first part of the exercise. Classifying. We have a primary carbon here. Primary carbon here. Secondary carbon. Getting close. I know it has three bonds, but only two of them are to carbon. And this is called tertiary. It has three bonds to carbon, as is this one here. And I believe the only one that's missing here is this one, which we cannot call primary. Later we're going to learn this is called methyl. You can think of as methyl as zero dairy. And that is the end of this exercise.